Life is all about you, and not at all about you. Now that's two opposing thoughts, and yet both of them are true. How can you experience everything you choose to do, while observing the experience you're having from a higher view? See, it's the question, not the answer, that's the higher view. Otherwise, you couldn't differentiate between the two. Awareness, but of who? You think you hurt me, but I promise I was letting you. They say we're all one, but where have we been heading to? I'd rather die free than have to live inside a petting zoo. I am the journey that I'm getting to. This location. I am the map, so I travel back in time. I have everything I want because my imagination is mine. But mine is not enough for me because I am not my mind. I could see it all but never get to see. I'm truly blind. I could be it all, but all identity is intertwined. The moon is only bright because it reflects the sunshine. Chase, we do not run this place, but both medicine and poison's an acquired taste, so I started taking selfies of somebody else's face.
Oh, I don't know, sir.
Tell me something. What is more genius than a child's laughter? Are we not simply the children of this world?
Hey, traders, welcome to episode 683 of the show. You could be doing anything, but you're here. And I appreciate it, man. Sorry. There's a lot of moving pieces, okay? This is just, I don't know, man. What's going on back there? What was that? Here's the sun, dude. All right, that is the sun. Bitcoin is at 10,253. It's right around the same price it was at before the sell-off that occurred last night that brought me home from the bar to stream it. And a nice 786 retrace from the low to high. You bounced, man. Square up to the downside and now square up to the upside. Look at the 60-minute. Like, it's beautiful, man. It's freaking beautiful. The Gartley hit the PCZ, 786. Didn't quite hit the first target, which was like 10,453, if you were going to play that, right? Because it's a small pattern, and you're looking for C and A. Those are like your targets on something like this. So second target's like nearly 11K, 10,950. But I did say something about I would go streaking if this Gartley played out. I don't know if we could say it's played out. I'm talking like I'll go streaking if like this is what ushers in the continuation of the entire bull trend we've been in since the bottom in, you know, December through February, right? That 3150, 3343 area. So great news, but back to the middle of the range, the $1,500 range that you've been confined in since the 14th of August. Range-bound action for over a month now. Great. Ethereum held strong, but no one cares about Ethereum based on, you know, the views I got on my static video just reviewing it. Because, I mean, it was like, dude, it's up $10 today while all the other alts are, like, not doing well. I mean, like, XRP is down 4.4%. Bitcoin Cash down a little bit. Litecoin down a little bit. But, again, Ethereum's up, like, 5%, man. So, you know, dude, I mean, you're just running out of room, right? There's only so many times you can test critical supports from history, right? 2018. There's only so many times you can hit a downsloping resistance and not break it. You are getting squeezed in. I mean, you're running out of room. Speaking of that, you know, on the futures, I don't even think I looked at it yesterday. I should have. Oh my god, dude. Like, futures chart. Okay, so somehow, look, you were confined, and look, on the last day, like literally the only day you did this, rejected it, and broke to the upside, and now here we are at 10,300. About, you know, what, $44 away from spot price. So, dude, these are the times. All right, if you were, like, not caring about Bitcoin because lack of volatility, it's coming, man. It's definitely coming, the big move. It's like very, very high probability. Looking at the futures and the spot price, futures got nowhere to go, man. It's like out to the upside now. We'll see how that plays. That rejection weight was pretty good, man. Did the rejection on the futures went to 96.44? Okay. And then bounced like nothing. Just held. Look left once more. I mean, how many times are you going to hold it? Straight up another higher low than your previous low. You gotta be kidding me, man. There's no more room. No more. Oh, wow. Holy crap. Do we have 100 likes already? And we also have 420 people watching.
Is that a joy?
Dude, thank y'all for the 100 freaking likes. 115 likes. Jeez. Love is in the air. It's not even Valentine's Day. Dude, less than a month to my birthday. I can't wait. Well, I can, I guess. I guess getting older doesn't... It's not very good anymore. It's like not like something you look forward to. You're like, crap, my birthday is coming up. So there you go. All right, so let's talk about maybe making adjustments to the wicks, right? I didn't. I left this alone. I had 1, 2, 3, 4 plotted... Right on the channel.
Volatility troll man, hey.
Volatility troll tip $25. You rang?
VK doing things.
Did I rang Volatility troll? I don't know, man. I don't know. tonight's gonna be, you know, last night was lit, but tonight's the official lit night, right? Thursday nights have become like the official lit night, because who knows, on Fridays with football season, like, sometimes I'm not even able to make it, but we know Thursdays. So hey, bring it on, bro. Bring it on. So like, look, volatility troll chat, everyone making the adjustment there and just moving the downsloping channels trend line to confine the wicks that on the rejections, you can see we have not broken anything yet, right? So just continual contraction. This thing is 9 months pregnant. The water will break soon. Okay. Probes knows about it. He does. Little Probes knows about it too. Bitcoin knows about it. So, hey, look. I mean, here are lows on price on candle close is about the same candle close low, and lower levels of negative MOMO. That's Class B bullish divergence. It broke to the upside, but not our eyes, not yet. So it's like, you know, I think it's just still so neutral because, like, you just keep hitting the support, and it's like, how many buy orders are going to be there, right, before this thing blasts off or gets destroyed, right? Because if all the buy orders are people reaccumulating, yeah, move up. But, like, if the sellers are in control, and that's the problem with neutral patterns, you just don't know. Like, you have to wait for confirmation. I mean, there could be just a couple exchanges propping this price up, or a couple people propping the price up, trying to get out and distributing to not create a panic, because they might make this market. And eventually, once all their orders fill on the sell side, they, you know. Well, I mean, look, you can have people that prop the price up at the same time while they're distributing, right? And that's a lot of times what happens with descending triangles. And I'm not saying that's happening right now, but it could. And, like, if we did dump violently, you'd know why. Because it was like them distributing and also propping the price up while they got rid of their coins. Mr. Majesty, no, in Bitcoin, that's like 9 months, dude, okay? Wow, a trippy panic. I don't even know why you said that, man. Whoa! We're working on the cranes, man. Skyward, dude, help me out. Okay, so that's futures. Adjustment made, still contracted. You got until early October. If like the market participants wanted to keep Bitcoin within these two trend lines, the apex is right here. All right, 98.59. Okay. Ethereum Connect did a static video. Again, I don't think any of y'all watched it. Some of y'all did. But same analysis, nothing's changed, right? $220. Can't break the 3. You hit the 382. Fantastic. The beginning of the golden zone. All right, that is where it's a common area to reverse your price action now. If it was going to do it, like if market participants wanted to sell off here, this wouldn't be weird, right? It'd be weird before it, but now we made it. But if you're talking about a falling wedge trade, you're talking about 50% and 618 for your targets. You haven't quite gotten there, but you're getting there, man. Swing trading, it's not going to happen in a day. Pattern develops over the course of 2 months. It might take a few weeks to get to targets. So Brian Holm. I hope y'all had a wonderful Thursday. Is that true? 777 Athletic Man. EA Sports tweeted about invest in crypto. Well, they're doing a disservice because it's not technically investing. It's definitely speculating and gambling, man. All right. Too infantile of a market to call it investing. That's okay. All right. Excuse me. We'll get XRP. Wow. Chat. I mean, what do you call it? What did we literally talk about on Lit Wednesday night? What did we talk about was happening? You've got all day to recover, and we had all day, and we did it, man. XRP has recovered from the back test. You broke an old resistance, old support. It was resistance. It then became support. Great news. While at the same time trying to reset your oscillator. So, good. This is exactly what you need to do if you're an asset and you want to break to higher prices. In time, those targets, 34 cents to 40.5 cents for just common retrace levels. Thanks, Chuck Gray, man. Is this channel streaming every day, Brad Zabik? Yeah, it is, man. For the most part. Pretty consistent. It's for 18 months, maybe going on 19 months now. I don't even know anymore. So, Randy Bobandy? Yeah, William Battles. Thank you, dude. Oh, Mr. Sintan, what's up, dude? Sorry. So, again, man, all right? So, breaking, you're hooking. If you're lucky, you'll get a bullish engulfing candle next during the next few candles. Break, hook, and go confirmation. We have broken out. XRP is technically, in this context, it has had a breakout. It's more like a break in back to the zone, right? The outer zone, inner zone, you're back in it, dude. So, if you think about it, I mean, 35.5 cents. Seems like it would be the next area, the next real area, if we could hold this and engulf and go to it. All right. Above the 382 in the golden zone. Fantastic. Oh no, XRP is down 4% when it's up like, you know, extreme amounts before that. Give me a break, dude. Only people that are scared are FOMOers. All right. You had your opportunity. You don't even act like you didn't have an opportunity on all these altcoins that were showing daily divergence at critical supports. And some of them had patterns. Yeah. Don't get mad at me, man. Gary Dawson's 44 today. Congratulations, dude. Happy freaking birthday. Really, dude. So, Ray Robinson. Bit of a pump in the Moon Boys are back. I don't know, man. I don't think that at all. 540, that's like our base now. That's like kind of our... you know, our local support, you know, way back before all the pumps and stuff, right? I think we had like 200, 250 was kind of like the base. We have pretty much doubled our base of like real viewers that like care about trading and investing in themselves, which is great. Accumulation. So we get another run, maybe we'll accumulate another 100. So like on slow days or whatever, we'll get, you know, even more, right? And so that's just the way I think. I mean, streaming for 18 months sounds like a long time, but compared to a lot of people that have, like, millions of subs and have, like, you know, 5,000-10,000 people watching them every day, like, live concurrent average on Twitch and stuff, they've been doing it for over 5 years. And they're, like, those are, like, the original people. So, yeah, man, we're getting there. Some even had patterns, man. That's right, Time Hawk. You get it, dude. All right, so let's go to Litecoin. Sorry. Long scale. Remember, this is what we talked about last night. How interesting it was. It's the take on Litecoin in log scale. The same way I set up the trade on Ethereum. But, you know, in this situation, you haven't broken anything, have you? But, well, you have. It's not the Momo shift trend line, though. It's the horizontal line. Support resistance. Okay, I'm talking about between 71 and 7250. You broke it. You broke the chop. You're above it. You broke. You're back testing now, like XRP. Good, healthy price action. So, you know, I know we didn't break this, not yet, but we know in linear scale in the 4 hour, we certainly did. But you know, hey man, break. You've back tested, you're back testing again. Maybe the next candle is a bullish engulfing on the breakout in log scale on the daily. That'd be stupendous. Let's go to that 4 hour. Get out of log. Oops, let me okay. Remember the channel we were in for months? It all started buying climax June 22nd. And then just a few days ago, we busted out. We broke out. We didn't get a break, hook, and go. We got some sort of bullish harami. Break, hook, and harambe, dude. and, you know, anchoring one and two on the bottom, three on the top. As you can see, you had an up thrust, bearish Harambe, reverse the downside to do that back test. And now you're running again, but, you know, you're running again, you're getting near the same high, and you don't even have positive momentum yet. You don't even have, I mean, you are, you know, if you go to the same high, you might be showing some bearish divergence. And I think Ethereum might be showing it too soon. Okay. Yeah, Bitcoin pairs, some of them are breaking the upside, but the context is much different than the US dollar pairs, right? You got to think about, okay, what's different? The US dollar pairs had a stupendous run for most of the year, for 6 months roughly, right? And for the past, like, 2 months, a little over 2 months, they've been correcting after that initial run. The Bitcoin pairs, dude, not even close to being the same, right? They have been just getting destroyed and destroyed and destroyed. So, like, I think the context is much better for the US dollar pairs than the Bitcoin pairs right now, right? Because of the trend. All these altcoins made like 60% corrections, right? Some maybe were more. Brad, what happened, dude? That's weird. All right, whatever. I don't care. Pier 1 imports per. Okay. Yeah, we can take a look. Sure thing, Gary, man. All right. Dude, this music is super chill, but it might be too loud. Can I get a sound check? Because, like, my mic's too far away. Maybe that's a little better right there. Double Jesus
your stream
chimes.
Is so retro. Your stream is so retro. Kappa.
Wow, Claudio, dude, thanks for the Ethereum Classic. His signature contribution, man. Thank you, dude. Ha ha ha, Kappa. Yeah, because we got the echoing chimes from the days of old. The old overlay. Like, this is like the first, if you, well, it's the second, actually. The second moving overlay I ever had in the background, that blue. We good? It was perfect. It's not anymore. Gosh dang it, dude. We'll see, Dustin, man. So Ethereum, it's like, you know, links up from that area, from that, dude, still up. All right, it actually broke out. It tried to. It's failed. This is a daily log scale chart of an asset that went insanely high very fast. And so, you know, you've been selling off since June 30th, and you finally bounce September 13th, add a support that goes back to May 23rd, 2019. The reason probably why you bounced here, well, you were exhausted, right? I mean, you showed a low on price, a slightly lower low with much lower levels, almost inexistent levels of negative MOMO. And as you can see, the bounce. Yet you're still confined within the parameters of the downsloping channel. Trying to break, man, on link. And we talked about, even if you break out, you've got to break above 198 to 208. That is very important, all right? If you break 208, that area, well enough, see it $2.75, all right? Yes, ZRX is up nearly 20%. today. It's not like it didn't break out. Not like it had not been broken out. Right? Class B divergence all the way. Blast off. And it's now hit and touched. That to Jesus, man. The beginning of the golden zone. These were the targets that you could have retraced to. 24 cents to 29.31 cents. You're there, man. You did it. Big round of applause for
please clap.
ZRX.
We have 20%.
Rounding bottom. Joseph Madden, thanks so much for the sub, dude. Welcome. Hey. I think we did education up here one before. Double bottom? I don't know about that. It looks like some rounding action. Looks like you had a wedge and you broke out of a wedge of some sort, right? Where, yeah, I get it. You're like, is this a double bottom? Maybe. Maybe it's a large double bottom. Also looks like, Momo shift trend line. You know, look, dude, this thing is falling off a cliff. I mean, March 2009. You were pretty freaking close, man. Like less than a dollar away from touching it. So like a 99% retrace. And maybe on the 99% retrace, the weekly could probably show up. It might show up. Let's see. Excuse me. I don't even know, dude. Just don't worry about it. Weekly. Yeah, maybe. Right, so support. Springing. You actually broke it and then back tested it. Now you're running again. If you wanted to look at it like some sort of weekly double bottom, welcome to position trading. Holy crap. Wow. Can't say not areas of value, maybe. So we got a low. We got a slightly lower low. Oh my God. Art of JR, dude. Weekly. Class A. Bullish divergence is super classy, dudes. All right. We're talking like monocle, top hat, orange tuxedo. Classy, dude. Forget the colors. All right. So class A bullish divergence at a very critical spot, man. Crap.
TA King. Hi, Pinajad.
Hi, Pinajad.
Dude, Dustin, man. Sorry, this is all...
Is that a joke?
Like, I have two different overlays now, so it's not going to be easy. All right, you can see, like, if you tip me when I'm on my other screen, I might just have to not deal with that. It's so... This is why I couldn't have nice things on my other PC. Dude, the way Stream Elements works, and the jar, and all that stuff. I have two different jars, two different overlays. I have to. There's just no way to do it or get around it. So, anyway, don't worry about it. So, yeah, maybe wedge on the daily, but on the weekly. Could be something brewing, chat. Shout out to Art of JR. Sorry. Okay, Adam and Eve. Adam and Steve, whatever you want to call it. Some mega mega Twitch streamer got banned for saying that there are only two genders. I found this out today. It's pretty crazy, man. The world we live in. Do I even really even need to applaud this? It's so perfect, right? Adam and Eve with Weekly Dapper. Come on, chat. All in Pier 1, Kappa. But at the same time, not Kappa. Wow. Art of JR setting himself up for maybe the, he's in the running now. We can plot all this or write it down. Okay. Very good, dude. I know, no control. Adam Steve is not. It's Adam and Eve, yes. Because Steve would be another V, right? That's not America, dude. It's like the world. It's like globalism. It's like a movement. Well, really all that kind of stuff, I think, stems from... Well, you know, a lot of it's like that Marxism stuff, and that came from the KGB spending an absorbent amount of money, their budget, infiltrating the Western education system, and I think it's really gone from there. The whole point was to overthrow a society, right? Like Western society, freedom, democracy, right? And you demoralize an entire generation of people. Anyway, not politics, we're not going to talk about it. You may know some stuff about it. All right. Dang, dude. That's so nice. Pier 1. Let's go. Big stay on the stock market, right? Party City is back up 5% today. Party Parrot. Let's go, man. But we can try to keep it more crypto, all right? But good news, man. Great news for ZRX, all right? About time. I mean, what did you have to do? You had to get destroyed, lose your entire life? Yeah, had to be a loser coin forever before finally breaking to the upside. And what are you doing, right? What are you doing on this break to the upside? You're trying to break back into the range you fell out of where we had here. It was like between 22 cents and... 39.5 cents, you're trying to get back into it. We'll see if we can back test it like XRP has done, like Litecoin's trying to do. Let's see if we can back test, and then maybe we can run again to higher prices. Possible. Sorry, man. That's right, six, man. Well, I'm full of surprises, dude. So what have y'all been talking about? Sorry, dude, we looked at things. I want to look. I want to chill for a sec. What's up, J-Mo, man? Hi, Desert Gardens here. Hi. Bullish stiletto. I guess, dude. I think it's still contained within a channel. But whatever. It maybe isn't. No. Oh my god. Y'all, seriously. Not a joke. Not a freaking joke. Watch this. We're going back to it just for a sec. One and two. And three, you are out. You broke it, made the slightly lower low, held outside of the channel you were in, and now you're rounding out. And dude, I'm telling you, Pier 1 could be in for a nice one, a real nice one. High to low for a retrace. Could go between 77 and 121. Sounds insane, like I'm a crazy person right now, but that's how it works. Hype in the chat for Pier freaking 1. You better add it to your watch list. These are areas to take longs, positions. This is the area. I'm Pier 1. Okay. I need another monitor, man. Well, my solid state came in, my M2 solid state, but I don't know how long it's gonna take for my IT guy to be able to come over here to install it and do all the stuff he's gotta do, you know, to make sure I'm good to go. James Glenn, hey, thank Art of JR, dude. Right? Don't thank me. And thanks for the 581 people, and holy crap, thanks for the 250 likes. Are you kidding me? Dude, seriously, thank y'all. So early in the stream, so many likes, so much love. Remember, you like me. I love you, dude. Okay, so that's ZRX, man. That's crazy gains, right, on the day. It's going to Maker up 8.5%. Right, what was it, man? The pseudo harmonic. There it is, dude. The triple MACD bullish divergence at a 78.6% retrace. I'm saying maybe it never hit down here, but there's a reason why. And it was because you had a very deep retrace, a level of value, 78% retrace. And the divergence played its role. And it looks like you've broken the upside now. Now, let's see if we can, that target would have been on entry here around $800. What? Bearish range. You're just range bound and you were near the lower points of the range but did not hit the actual bottom of the zone or just the beginning of the zone. And that's okay. But at least it just gives perspective. Very educational, this Maker to US dollar. Again, up. Up with Zerks and Ethereum and Link. Those are it though. Everything else is kind of in the red. Not many other assets up at all. Remember me walking through Atlanta? Oh, I remember. That was when, the BTC pairs. It was the last time there was real opportunity for the BTC pairs. That was before Bitcoin took off to the moon, man. And all the BTC pairs ran out of time. Remember, they were all setting up for higher prices. Many of them got to their targets on the trade setups. And then it was just April 1st rolls around. No more. No more BTC pair trades. It was like the meta changed. It shifted. And Bitcoin went to nearly 14K. It broke the wall like White Walkers, dude. Oh boy. Yeah, look, when I was talking about the politics, I wasn't talking about let's talk about many
What's
things
up,
that have to
brother
do with
politics. Brother man, I hope all is well. How's college football treating you? Much love, King.
Fan-freaking-tastic, Lone Sofos, man. Marco Rivera, man, let's go.
Please Marco quiet. Rivera tipped $25. Always good to see you streaming live, Mitch. We all appreciate you very much. Clinking beer mugs.
Clinking beer mugs. Thank you, dude. Oh, boy, the sun's going down, so my lighting's getting orders. Here we go. Dude, really, thank you. You and everyone, my God.
Get ready, Mitch. Ready to be naked. You know it's a moon from here.
I don't know, man. I don't know that 60 Minute Gartley is going to usher in the entire continuation of the bull trend we've been in for most of the year. All right. I'm sorry. I just don't know. But yeah, it was kind of like the rule. I'd go streaking if this Gartley made it so. That means we have to break out of the downside resistance. That means we have to back test it, hold it, and then run again to much higher prices. We have no idea that's going to happen. All right. But college football, how's it treating me? Wonderful. So good that I spent most of the money I made last weekend to get front row. I mean, we're talking, first row, 40-yard line tickets to the Alabama LSU game. So that's going to be, I'm excited about that. It's like, why not, you know? And so this weekend I've got a 3-game teaser. I've got a variation of a 3-game teaser with two anchors. All right, so it's LSU minus 13.5. 10-point teaser, okay? Minus 13.5 against Vandy. I've got Oregon versus Stanford. It's a minus half a point, meaning they just need to win, right? I think they will probably kill Stanford this year. And then I've got Georgia minus 4. All right? Write those down if you care, right? If you even follow my college football stuff. So, yeah, let's see how it goes, man. Did the exact same thing last week. It was wonderful. No, no one's going to be able to watch it, Julia, because I'm not going to get banned. All right. Did XMR just pump? No, it's down 6.5%. I think it's still inside the channel, unfortunately. Oh, it's trying to get back out. Right? So this is what happened on XMR, where you broke out, then Bitcoin volatility picked up and it dumped, and where did Monero go? It dumped too. Yet there is an upsloping channel you can see you're confined within. You just ran down to touch it. And once you touched it, once you back-tested old resistance as support, you're running again. And if you can stay out of this channel that signifies momentum shifting to the upside, you might see a run. And there are targets, 93.46, 100, 109, right? Those are targets if one's trading Monero on a breakout of a channel. This is a standard Momo shift trade. Okay, potential. These are just targets for it. If you take your position. I don't do NFL. I don't research it or study it and never played it. You know, none of that. So I don't know, dude. I wish them best of luck though. So it's great. But I mean, like Jacksonville or Tennessee, dude, I don't know. I don't even know the players on the team. I don't even know. I think, they both used to suck so bad, and maybe one's good again. I don't know. So Charlie Lee's bags, man. You can't get banned from Discord. Famous last words, right? JMO is going to take one for the team and streak across the field, the Bama LSU game. Dude, if you did it, that'd be lit.
Is that a joint?
Oh, dude, that's tomorrow, right?
At the Area 51 rape commence.
Dude, that's tomorrow. You know, it'd be sweet if I could get a live stream of it behind me while I stream. That would be freaking lit. Man, I'm going to change up my background, dude. What should I change my background to, chat? Give me some ideas, okay? Let's have fun with this. I need some input. All right? And while we do that, we can look at BAT to the US dollar, see how it's fared. I don't think it's really moved much. It might have recovered a little bit from the sell-off, but wasn't bad. Yeah, it's going. It's up 2.29%, man. Come on, dude. Let's go. Freaking bad attack. I mean, how many times in the history of mankind have we had an asset that is the same name of a harmonic, and then it shows up on the daily time scale, has coinciding variables, and then begins to start playing out near the PCZ? Someone tell me how real that is, right? How often that happens. I think this is a very rare event. BAT breaking the BAT to the upside. Why would I do flaming background? That's weird, dude. Underwater and fish, Marco? Is that what you want, dude? Forecast? I mean, these are, if you're trading, it's not even a forecast, dude, because I'm not forecasting that it's going to go here. I'm saying if one's trading with a stop loss below X, these are targets that one would go for. That's it. $0.4285 and $0.5029 if this trade played out completely. All right. No, I'm streaming from the backup PC still, but overwhelming demand for chat, right? And I didn't like it either. I was like watching the stream last night. I'm like, dude, this sucks because I want to see what people are saying, right, while I'm streaming. So it's great for the VOD, right? Most people that stream, they don't even care about their VODs. They don't even like keep their VODs up. They just take them down because there's just little value in it. But you know, you could watch a stream from like a year ago and you might learn something watching it, even though so much time has gone by since then, right? Oh yeah, a lot of people got arrested. Looks like ETGate got no hope. Yeah, there's no way. Marcel, we just looked at the link like, I don't know, 10 minutes ago or something. Wait, do we not get enough ideas? We got fish underwater. Space shuttle, dolphin. This is in Grandma's Boy, dude.
Space shuttle.
A swamp? I don't know, man. Not near enough ideas. Okay. Whatever, I guess we'll keep it till then. You rewatched a few old videos of Bitcoin breaking out of the bottom last night, Johnny? Dude, yeah, it sucks. My most viewed video ever, it was a 10-hour live stream. It got taken down for one song. 44,000 views. I still have it. I watched some of it, a few days ago. I'm just like looking at chat, just like, you can't even read anything. It's ridiculous. Thing to say. Jeez. Remy, you got some serious issues, dude, to be saying that. Like, I don't care if you're talking to me or someone else. You should never be saying crap like that. So, JDR? Unicorn? I don't know, man. Yeah, I got Chaylin working on some stuff for the Vet Moon Boy. You know, space and like spaceships and like a background for me being Vet Moon Boy. All right. Okay, anyway, that's Batman. What do you want, dude? What do you want with Bat? This is like getting its additive reversal area. I mean, it never quite hit the exact number of the PCZ, but mother God, if you can't say it didn't get close enough to it, right? Kind of double bottoming too, if you zoom in, probably in the 4 hour, 60 minute, you can see a double bottom here. If you hadn't broken it, breaking double bottom is probably around 21 cents. Great. Great news. Let's see, like Tron connects down. Dash is down. Not really. Dash is about the same. 88th down. That's okay, right? Cardano, man, give me a break. How perfect it was. It doesn't get more perfect than this, man. I don't think. Here we go, Alexander. Thanks for watching again. I don't know, man. You know, daily close. Sometimes we see volatility, but more often than not, we don't. I just like being here because I know it's like when Asia's waking up, right? A lot of people over there are waking up on that side of the world, and also people are coming home from work in, you know, North America. It's just a good time slot, I think. Show a stream in the background of my stream. TAception. Maybe, dude. Interesting idea. Okay, so that's ADA, XLM. After its blast off, it's still fine. I mean, look what it did, chat. It broke back above the ice line and is now back testing it as support. You get a candle, all right? You get another candle on the daily that engulfs this candle. That's a break, cook, and go confirmation. And it could go much higher. You were overbought. You're at 70 now, right? Right around there. You're still overbought, 70.76. So yeah, give it time for these oscillators to cool off on the daily, the 4 hour, 60 minute, and all that. And hopefully Bitcoin, you know, for alts, you don't want Bitcoin to be volatile, even to the upside probably. You probably want it to be just calm, up, down, whipsaw, you know, like sideways price action, if you want alts to do well, right? But I can't say anything about, you know, most of the time, the way the meta's gone is like, if Bitcoin's volatile to the upside or downside, it's not really good for alts, right? Alts seldom are matching Bitcoin's performance when it does things crazy. Yeah, I don't know if there's like a zebras jumping over rainbows in the background. I don't know if there is a, you know, type of background like that, dude. But I could definitely see what's out there. I just don't know, man. All the underwater ones look terrible. The underwater ones, they just don't look that great, man. I don't know, man. Oh. It's not gonna, it doesn't last long, though. Hold on. I got this, man. Oops. Oh, man. We might be onto something. Just Bitcoin, man. He just sitting back there, dudes. Like, no big deal. I dig it, man. Not bad. You know, like, unlimited opportunity for this. Be more fun when I have a hat on, though, so we can theme the hat, my hat, with whatever the background is. Vice versa. Okay, so great news. Some of these alts just going through a little hangover, but the hangover was needed, right? You get drunk, you gotta have a hangover. Okay. Otherwise, you can't drink again or something. Dolphin, right? Figure it out, little bruises. Okay. Neo down nearly 4%. That's okay. Not really backtesting. I mean, maybe you could say it's trying to backtest this January 9th and March 16th level as support. Not really, though. Okay. So, yeah, if high to low, critical thinking would lead you to believe that the golden zone for just a common retrace, 1320 to 1617. It's just where Neo in time could go. Dude, I don't really care about Bitcoin pairs, dude. I just, it's so inefficient. I gotta trade 4 times before I'm settled up, dude. That's so stupid. Sucks having Dang, dude, 300 likes? Are you kidding me? Hop in the chat for the likes. Y'all incredible, man. Okay, so been live about an hour now. And it really is time for... your local on the eights, Matt. Altcoins, I mean, they very well could just be... it could just be the beginning. We could see these alts go higher if it's not a complete fake out. I mean, Bitcoin's at 10,241. When at one time earlier it was at 10,300 plus. So it went down a little bit, but still up on the day when at one point we were down 5%. Very nice bounce off a crazy critical support, daily support. So a breakout at this point is around, I mean, it is not far away. It could be 10,400, 10,350. Running out of room, man. We could break and back test. Maybe the next area where we sell off is like 11,600. So good. Then going back to 60 minute real quick on Bitcoin. Or being range bound. Think about it. Down here, we had a square up. We sold off to square up to hit the 786. And then it broke to the upside. And then it squared up again, right around 10,140, right? Squared up right there. And now it's running again. And no square ups here. The next real square up. Next real square up's around 10,866. Seriously, man, there's no more square ups now. I mean, unless you're talking about the downside. Downside probably around 10,115. Been right around 98.94. Okay. Maybe we get a 60 minute flag or something before going again. Overbought. You were overbought in 60 minutes. Very tough to keep going when you get overbought so fast. So, JMav. Well, I looked at it. His back testing is good. It had a breakout or a break in where it broke out of a range that it was in and is now back testing the old range. The word's resistance is now support. All right, so there we go. New hours here for real. And it's the last hour of the day, last hour of the 4 hour candle. It is power hour. And you get like Jerry Ragsdale to make like something called, like, and I can just use it on my stream deck where it's like power hour or something stupid, you know, like I do local on the eights, also power. You know, I haven't, a game I haven't played since college, power hour, like literally power hour, where you have beer, like water beer, and you take a shot of beer, just like a shot glass of beer, every minute for 60 minutes. Not an easy game, but it might be fun to play. Do y'all think I can do it? I could probably do it. I mean, people say it's tough, but I did it in college successfully, but I had someone playing with me, so it was like keeping me accountable. Man, that'd be not easy streaming, I guess. That's right. Bitcoin breakout very soon, one way or another. Absolutely. And look no further than the futures chart just to see, I mean, what's occurring. We looked at this earlier in the stream. We'll look at it once more, just for those coming in that didn't get a chance to see. Oh my God. Talk about contraction, connect. Oh yeah. Sloping support. Look how you fell out of it and then rallied and closed back above it. Are you effing kidding? And now here we are just going sideways. More indecision. Like, what? Whatever, man. Not really moving. Oh my god, dude. What's happening? The light. More. I'm losing light. Should be that. Alright, so lift that up. Alright, that should be good right there. Green screen connect, man. Don't like this? I don't know. Because it's like, no one can even see what it is behind me, right? Because, like, that's where my head is. So, it's okay, though. It's like the Matrix or something. So, how are we responding on moving averages, right? I mean, I haven't looked. See, you're, like, below the... That's bad. I don't like that. That's real bad. Your moving averages are starting to point to the downside a little bit. They're angled down sloping and you're rejecting them and you just can't seem to break above them. Because you want to be using them as support, bouncing off of them, and you want to see them pointing upwards or beginning to point upwards. Right? Where like at a time you're here and it was pointing downwards still, but then you broke them. Really broke them. Then you came and back tested them as support for a while. And that was after the breakout. And so then April 1st, bam. All right, then Golden Cross ensued later in the year to May 17th. And you just kept staying above them. But now it's different, right? It's like you're above your moving averages for now. Kappa, below them. So you've got to get above them at some point. Otherwise, yeah, not looking too hot. We're trying, yeah, trying, but there's just no volatility. And this is just, you know, it's kind of reactionary to Bitcoin. Spot price kind of calls the shots, kind of tails it. Get her done, Lord Baltimore. Thanks, dude. You too. Look like a saint with a ring around my head. Dude, this is the old school Halo, dude. This is what Halos came from, man. Right, all I have to do is this, and now we're back in the 13th century, dude.
Peace be upon you. For I have the Halo now.
What's up, Gobi, man? Thank you for the sub. If you enjoyed the live stream, hit that like button, that bell, that sub. Majesty, who you talking to, dude? Bitcoin surfer, I agree, man. Who would go surfing on the waves, dude? Bitcoin surfing. Dude, there's just unlimited potential here. I can't wait. I feel like a kid in a candy store with a green screen. Being able to, like, implement what you all love, the chat and stuff, and it's like having our cake and eating it, too. It's just there's no jerseys. It's not my office, my main office. But, hey, man, if you can make your main office literally anything you want... Pretty lit. If time is money, then money is time. Sure. Lower highs, but higher lows. Price contraction, neutral. It's okay to have a neutral pattern. And it's just like, I think everyone just wants to act like they know what's going to happen with Bitcoin. When it's okay to say, hey, the pattern that's developed is neutral. And there are many other assets that exist on different markets and this market that were showing impending price action versus the upside. All right. Paulo Gust, what's up, dude? Love. So I want to talk about, just for a second, I posted it to patrons today. One I'm looking at very carefully and getting close, very close and ready. Baba? I'm looking for my watch list, man. There it is. Look at that reject. Look at that. Holy crap, the way the day ended. My God. It got as high as $184 before closing at 180. 46, the lowest low of the day. A freaking bearish hammer shooting star. Good God. What a rejection. And look at this textbook Gartley. Bearish Gartley, man. What dreams are made of. But it never quite hit the PCZ. It was about a dollar and a, you know, $1.52 off hitting the exact entry. Okay. Didn't it was like it all it like went up to touch my alert. It did go off. I know my alert did go off today. So it's just wild, man. It seems it's almost ready. And the 4-hour divergence is there, daily divergence is pretty much there, like a high, a higher high. Lower levels, positive MoMo, right? It's beautiful though. It's like this is one that you could put in a book, in a textbook, on Garleys. Or potential Garleys, whatever. Sir Charles, yeah, I do that already with my, you know, I use the weather and season stuff like for where the blue is moving. Like that's normally like nature scenes and stuff. Yeah, I could do something like that. Let me see what I can do. Hold on. Might be good. I don't know if it's gonna be good or not. Beautiful, man, right? It's like an autumn afternoon. You know, the leaves are turning. There's the rock, man. I am the rock. Sometimes streaming is the river.
Oh my God. Volatility troll tipped $23.58. What's the entry and stop on Baba? I'm driving and will call my broker.
Don't call the SEC, volatility troll. I can't tell you. I'll just say what I might do. Okay? I might have an entry. I'm not saying you should do ever. Okay? Not financial advice at all. But I might have an entry at 186.76. I might have a stop loss of 197.75. And I might take profit if I took a short at 152 and 147. That's it, dude. Okay. Literally, you shouldn't do it. That's what I would do. Okay, does that make sense? Mr. Volatility Troll. Things at 2358. Fantastical. UCLA. Bruins. Can we get some feedback on the background, please? Somebody? Dude, 342 likes. Y'all are incredible, man. Like, I don't even know what to say. Probably John Doe. I don't know. I hear Oregon is absolutely incredible because of all their maples up there. In Oregon.
XRP8 my Oreos. Great job, Mitch.
But JMAP, thanks for the $10 contribution. And, well, I'm sorry to hear that. It sounds terrible that XRP would do that to you. But, hey, one day at a time. You might get some more Oreos back tomorrow. All right. Better than it killing your father, man. Okay, XRP, you know, just for fun. What am I music, man? Looks like it all ended. We good, dude. So yeah, just back at XRP. Remember it broke out, rallied, hit a 382 from that high to low, was over. Hit the beginning of the golden zone, that's what happens. Sometimes 382 is it. And it sold off, it held, and dropped again to its, I mean, pretty much you don't want to be going below that. You break below 25 cents, you're going to 15 cents. But at this last line of defense area, right, divergence developed on the MACD at first, and then the RSI, and then the 4-hour, and then when it all converged after the Gartley, it became Kings. Like, you gotta just be like, how hilarious is it, dude, that this ushered in all this? So yeah, it's like the downtrend, the channel or whatever, you broke it, fell back in it, and now you've broken it again, and you're trying to back test it. Remember, it was resistance, now they're just trying to use it as support, see what holds. But I mean, look, you know what could be going on for real? Really tough to say, right? You want to say this is the swing low, or this, or this? You know, X, A, B, C, D. You'd hate that. You'd hate for XRP to fall below 28 cents. Like, what you've done is so good, and the last thing you want is to fall back in below this area. So important to stay above all this chop, not fall back below it. That's worst case scenario, man. All right, so, just know, common retrace levels, 34 to 40.5 cents, okay? Thank you again, JMav, for the Oreos.
Okay.
Though these alts have just begun to run, I think they went nuclear on the oscillators and had to cool off. They're doing their respective back tests. Artur Patak, thanks so much for the sub, dude. Welcome. Thanks to all the new subs. I have no idea how many subs I have anymore. YouTube makes it like impossible to really know exactly how many subs you have. Let me obsess over my sub count if I want to, dude. Like, it's up to me. It's my choice. All right. People can pick their own gender. I can pick my own, you know, obsessions. 20,141 subs now. Let's go, dude. 30K is the big one, man. I mean, like, 30K is the biggest milestone you can get on YouTube. Okay, the biggest for a streamer. It'd be hilarious if you could pick the background and I not know what it is. Yeah, that's a pretty cool idea. Pretty cool idea. I just don't know how it would work, right? Like, you'd actually have to have access to my PC to do that, and that's kind of monkey-ass, right? Charge up the limit break. Hey, every time a sub happens, Bitcoin server, it happens. You know. I know it's like old news. Did y'all see like the new, like, recreated Final Fantasy VII? That game looks pretty freaking lit. I might actually buy that to just use my 2080 Ti just to play through it, man. It's like a new combat system and all that. It's lit. Freaking lit. Is that a bump and run reversal bottom on XRP? It's one of the 4-hour. Kinda, yeah. I mean, anytime you break out of a channel or down some resistance, yeah, momentum shift. But it's really not that clear, is it? You can almost get rid of it and just look at horizontal lines, keep it simple. That is what matters over everything. 28.8 cents. Stay above it or you're screwed. Stay above it long enough, you will rally to higher prices, much higher prices, okay? That's all I got to say about that. Back to Litecoin for a moment to look at its real bump and run breakout, right? That is bump and run stuff, Momo shift. And it has much higher prices it could go to as well. And it's just back tested the 7250 area. And that was discussed before that even happened, what it could do. It did it, and it's good. Back tests are forms of confirmation to the market and saying, okay, that's over. All right, time to go much higher now, or the other way around, right? Did they finally make it? I don't know if it's out yet. The playthrough and all that started coming out. E3 of this, you know, that was like, I think June or May or something, June. So yeah, you just go check it out, Canatomo. Like, it's all on YouTube. It's fantastic. The background is as calm as the Bitcoin action, Mo Ghazali. I don't know. We dropped to like 9,600 something last night and are back to 10,252. I would not call that a spring, right? Not call it like a meadow or a rivulet. Now this is more of a, could this be considered a rivulet, chat? Definitely looks like it. Looks a little too small to be called a river. Way too small to be called a river. A creek, a stream. It's kind of like a spring, but I think rivulet could work here. We could get away with it schematically, right? Someone, dive me up on that. It releases March 3rd, 2020. Thanks, Russell, man. That's Final Fantasy VII, the new one. Interesting to see if Bitcoin pumps or dumps on the 23rd. There's a crazy article Larly brought up about silver back in 1980. Kind of compares silver to what's happening with Bitcoin. So Bitcoin's a free market construct, so one doesn't root against it no matter how obnoxious many Bitcoin promoters are. However, the moment Bitcoin threatens central banks, it will be squashed in seconds, just as the Hunt brothers were squashed on Silver Thursday. They call it Silver Thursday. Back in 1980, Nelson Bunker Hunt, Lamar Hunt, and William Herbert Hunt, the sons of the Texas oil billionaire Haroldson Lafayette Hunt Jr., had some time been attempting to corner the market in silver. In 1979, the price for silver jumped from $6.08 to a record high of $49.45. And that was... 18-day period that occurred. So a 713% rise back then. And again, 18 days. The brothers were estimated to hold one-third of the entire world supply of silver, other than that held by governments. The situation for other prospective purchasers of silver was so dire that on March 26, 1980, the jeweler Tiffany's, y'all have heard of that, took out a full-page ad in the New York Times condemning the Hunt brothers and stating, "We think it is unconscionable for anyone to hoard several billion, yes, billion dollars worth of silver and thus drive the price up so high that others must pay artificially high prices for articles made of silver." But on January 7th, 1980, in response to the Hunt's accumulation, the exchange rules regarding leverage were changed. When the COMEX adopted Silver Rule 7, placing heavy restrictions on the purchase of commodities on margin. The Hunt brothers had borrowed heavily to finance their purchases, and as the price began to fall again, dropping over 50% in just 4 days, they were unable to meet their obligation, causing panic in the markets. The Hunt brothers had invested heavily in the futures contracts through several brokers, including the brokerage firm Bach Causey, Stuart Shields, later Prudential Bach Securities and Prudential Securities. When the price of silver dropped below their minimum margin requirement, they were issued a margin call for $100 million. The Hunts were unable to meet that margin call, and with the brothers facing a potential $1.7 billion in losses, the ensuing panic was felt in the financial markets in general, as well as the commodities and futures. Many government officials feared that if the Hunts were unable to meet their debts, some large Wall Street brokerage firms and banks might collapse. To save the situation, a consortium of U.S. banks provided a $1.1 billion line of credit to the brothers, which allowed them to pay Buck, which in turn survived the ordeal. The U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission later launched an investigation of the Hunt brothers, who had failed to disclose that they in fact held 6.5% stake in Buck. So, is anyone going to corner the market on Bitcoin? Do we know? So, it's like the article, like the author of the article says, he does not propose anyone will corner Bitcoin, but theoretically it can happen. Instead, he proposes central banks will suddenly, without warning, change investment rules on Bitcoin.
What do you think about BTC on the weekly? Looks like a possible bounce on 21 Ma. Also Hexo, possible inverse head and shoulders, if doesn't keep selling off.
Fishhead, dude, thanks, man, for the threes. Yeah, we'll look at Hexo. Thank you, dude. And we'll look at Bitcoin on the weekly as well. Weekly Connect. Okay. So, anyway. He proposes that central banks will suddenly, without warning, change investment rules on Bitcoin if the price gets high enough for central bankers to be threatened, right? Well, that's what happened with silver. What is that price? He doesn't know, nor does anyone else. It would only be observable after the fact. If you think Bitcoin is immune to central bank actions, you are only nuts. The best thing for Bitcoin would be if it consolidates in a reasonable range, 4,000 to 12,000 for decades. Only after a long, non-threatening period of stability will Bitcoin be viable as a transaction mechanism as opposed to a speculation mechanism. And he says he does not expect Bitcoin to play out that way. Sweet. All right, whatever. It's a little bit of cool stuff to talk about, right? Commodity.
Nippon Cowboy Man, yes it has.
It must be for you too. My climate's very, very similar to a lot of places in Japan. At least South Japan. Okay, so weekly, he's talking about a moving average or something. 20 moving average. Yeah, chat, look. Real life. I mean, it's like this, dude.
Oh, would you look at that?
Finally, the moving average has caught up to the price. The price action, the candles. And here you are, holding it. Pennant. This is a pennant. Impulse. Consolidation. Could bring to the upside or downside. So yeah, stay above the 20 long enough and you'll be good. 98.17 is that exact number. Good. Paper gold is not gold. XRP is not crypto. Uh-oh, shots fired. Hey man, if we can trade it, who cares, dude, right? Like, whatever. Seriously. Okay, let's go to the other asset. What was it? Hexo Connect or something. Well, that's not good. Dude, I can't tell this music sucks or not. Hold on. That sucks, dude. Hold on. Sorry. So, what's the question about Hexo? Inverse and shoulders on Hexo. It's almost like a bear pole, bear flag. On the weekly, anyway. Doesn't look so great on the weekly, dude. At all. Yeah, but yeah, maybe on the daily it looks like that, certainly. Kind of off, though, right? Kind of like a lower high, like double bottom. The double bottom failed, right? And now it's selling off again. Rate 375, you're screwed. So maybe. Maybe you'll see the retrace.
Heaven to chat. Better music.
You're an 88% retrace. You bounced twice at the 88%. And when you bounce twice, you failed. Oh, dude, it almost looks like a descending triangle argument could be made now, right? Thank you. Why can people cherry pick on Bitcoin on what's a descending triangle when it looks almost like it's perfectly setting up for one here? No one says anything, right? I mean, it could be a reversal. Sure, it certainly could. Sorry, that's really loud, my bad. Sounds of the Forest music box. We can do that. Look what I can do, chat. Look what I can do to add to this level of brilliance. All right.
What? He can't do anymore, man.
He can't do anything else to make this even cooler. I'm trying to remember that. Quiet down, River. There it is. Let the leaves. Where are they, man? What's going on? Something's going on. Give me a sec. Oh, that's right. It's on the wrong thing. I'm on another thing now. Another different scene, so it doesn't work. It's okay, I can still do it. Dude, where is it? Found it. Let's go, hype and chat. So descending triangle may be on hexa, maybe inverse or but yeah, maybe dude. Okay, well, this is the entry. It's not a, it's like, keep wide of bearish and gold today. Maybe. So look, if you look down it that way, which I don't even know, because it's like they're the same here, same low on the wicks. I mean, if you did play it like that, measure move. If it ever broke the triangle, right? The downsliding resistance, measure move is 550. Okay? That easy, man. Dude, is it too bad? Maybe I should do a... Stream? Oh, it certainly is, dude. Good clean water. What's up, Cranburger? Okay, everyone had to go to the bathroom. Sorry. No more. Okay. What's up, Pablo, man? Sir Charles? Hey, lost your gun? Slayer River, you are obsessed with bat, dude. Like, you've never asked about any other asset but bat, meaning you might be tunnel visioned on one asset too much, man. Alright? You're asking me if Bitcoin falls, would BAT maintain its current levels? No, because it's freaking BAT, dude. It's freaking BAT. Are the birds chirping too much, man? I can't even tell. Dude, I can't. It's too much, man. It's not even. It's just birds chirping. You can't hear anything else. Sorry, dude. I'm not gonna have it. Put it on a jacket if you're going out in the cold. Ugh, it's getting a little chilly out here. Ugh. That's right, King. It goes. You got it, man. Carly did play out on the same level as the 21 weekly MA. What are you talking about, dude? Huh? I don't know what you mean. Anyway, all right. That's good, man. Ooh, we got like an hour and 30 minutes live now. If you're enjoying the live stream, that like button, that bell, that sub, like spike, sub spike, let's go. Everything spike for autumn coming. Not quite, it was still like 90 degrees today where I live, so. You like the birds? What's up, Arcantos? My prediction for Bitcoin, I don't do predictions, but I'll tell you, there's a neutral pattern that has been in development for months now. We've been in a correction, 80 days plus now. And on the stock market, on average, corrections last between 90 to 100 days. So we are right getting very close to that sweet spot of correction time. And so I think a break, you're nearing the apex. This coming, man. Volume very, very low. What kind of volume? My mic volume? Gosh, dang, I can't make it any better. Like, I have, like, this void of space here in the microphone. There's, like, only one place to have it, the desk. Okay. Maybe I should just turn my audio down on my music. And then you just turn me up. What's this guy talking about? Listen. Talking too much, dude. Kind of pissing me off. Okay, so just wanted to bring up the weekly again on Bitcoin because we talked about it before. We'll talk about it again. Weekly hidden bullish divergence, impending price action continuation. You got it, man. Clear as day, dead to rights. You don't know what he's saying, but you like it. That's right, A-Day. Me too. Maybe. Sam Wilson said everything's fine. Let the noobs suffer. Well, they can suffer. Leave Britney alone. That's right. Oh, he's talking about the charts on volume. He said, Mitch, the volume's very low. Yeah, I wouldn't worry about volume so much on Bitcoin. It's, most of it's done OTC, so... Fishhead, not yet, man. Not yet. It's got to, I told you, it's got to usher in the continuation of the bull trend that we've been in for most of the year. That's what it has to do. That's when I go streaking. Sounds good. All right, good. I don't know, man. I don't know how much longer I can stick around. Tonight is Patreon night. We're going to get lit. Probably have some beers. Talk about life, the universe, Uranus, north, south, east, the planets. It was like complete market penetration. Alright, and right now, you know, we're just still standing strong. Richard Grant says people complaining about music, volume. This stream is for the people who stayed when there was no volume, and now volume has come back, and they're here complaining. Fair weather fans, jeez. That was what Richard Curran said. Curran. No news to dump on, no real money, new money coming in. And that's why it's a neutral pattern, right? Contraction, dude. What is that? Sleepy cat, I don't know, steaking. Steaking a word? Is that a new thing? All these freaking leaves, man. My Roomba's kind of a field day. Playing a hot potato with alts? Maybe. I mean, again, like, you know what'll happen if Bitcoin dumps. All the alts' dreams will fade, most likely, into nothingness. Some people are saying that your comment, Richard Curran, is the highest comment of all time. All right. Liliana, get destroyed. You're not even, you're just a bot, a Russian bot, a scammer. No thanks, dude. Are there charts in Uranus? No, it's a gas planet. So, no. Pretty sick daily candle, just another candle of indecision. Just another one, man. But great news, another test of weekly support. And another, it seems, it's almost safe to say, another holds. You held again. Big time Hodor right now. Alright. Weekly, you just look at it like this, man. Just pin it to action. There it is. Beautiful little pennant nearing the apex. There's not much time left before the break, the violent break of the upside down set will occur. And thanks for the 550 people still here. Nice, man. Dude, we are less than 20 likes away from 400. Let's go, dudes. So close. I mean, Neal, see, look, you look at it. You can probably only fit like two more weeks inside of this thing, maybe three. Just know at this point how deep Bitcoin is in contraction, that you could wake up or just be working on something in IRL and all of a sudden, bam, your alerts go off and there was a huge red or green candle. All right. Make a big pile of the leaves and jump in them. I could not. Yes. I need some more autumn backgrounds. Like the base mat overlay backgrounds, not mine. They could match this. It'd be pretty freaking lit, dude. Not much longer. Bitcoin's, very undecided right now, dude. What about Zalanex? It was down. Earnings, it's a good semiconductor company. Dandy, 400 likes. Holy crap, man. Y'all are the best. Thank you all for the support as Bitcoin holds above that May 5th week, 2018, dreaded day, disgusting dump. Pump, dump, sideways, capitulation, recovery, kangs. Well then, Wayne, you could consider it maybe invalid. Well, Neil, the measured move of this pennant is about $4,100. Right, remember? It's low point to high point. I think being conservative here, not using this wick for the measurement. Okay, break to the upside. Measure moves 14,830. Maybe move it down a little bit. That's right. 14,500. It broke the downside. You're looking around 5,500. All right, that's how large this pattern is. It doesn't look like that big of a deal on the weekly, but on the daily, it's a huge symmetrical triangle. Very good. I see I don't have that sound clip, Johnny, like on this. There are a lot of things I just don't have here that I normally have on my main PC. Soon my main PC won't have anything, right? Because I'm like starting over from scratch. So crappy, dude. Jeez. So, what time? We got, I don't know, like 19 minutes or something until the daily close. I'll try to stick around, right? Gervais69 says, our RGB on keyboards makes your trades 10% more profitable. I think I can confirm. Can confirm. RGB keyboards enhance your trading abilities. Oh, but remember, I think having it on your mouse is very important too. And in your computer, if possible. Maybe your, you know, headphone stand. All of them. MoneyGram? I don't know, we can go back to MoneyGram. Continuing to sell, but that happens when you get so high so fast. Right, you were extremely overbought. I mean, you were at 88 on the RSI on the daily, broke a fib node, and now, hey, we talked about pattern development now. Impulse, let's look for something to be created here, and we can maybe trade it. Maybe it might, you know, be a rectangle or a wedge or a pennant or flag, whatever. Once it matures more, we can see it on the daily and might be able to take a position for higher prices. Bog news is not news if you know about it, okay? From June 9th. 61% redress. I don't know, man. Thought it was more than that. Thought it was deeper than that. But what are you talking about? Oh, yeah, yeah, I think, yeah, 61%. That's like the Garley, right? On Bitcoin, 60 minute. Little Conus, nah, man, y'all can summon me at any time if you want it. If you really want the hat, you can do it, make it happen. Any day you want. There's no bot news, it's just an exchange. Kevin, get wrecked, dude. Dang, dude, Texas Instruments to return more cash to shareholders with a 17% dividend increase, dude. Go get your quickulators. Go get your calculators, man. Oh, did y'all hear about the $40 billion program, buyback program for Microsoft? Hit all-time highs today. Brilliant, man. Yes, it's a boy, your boy Huss. Yes, I do. I mean, I haven't in a while, a long time. I don't think I've played real poker since I started streaming, dude. What's up, Rob Wynn? Neo, I don't, it had a bad day yesterday. I think it had not a very good one today either. Yeah, it's Neo. It's whole, I guess it's like, you know, impulse up flagging, like a little miniature flag, consolidation out of the impulse. Does seem fine to me. Seems fine. Consolidating. Very, very small, shallow retrace. Good. Give me the best flags like that. And let's go once more. Run it all the way up to nearly $4. NIO is fine. NIO, not NEO. NEO is fine too, I guess. For crypto. Fine. Like a fruit fly is fine, right?
Dude, I'm digging the song. So what is that? Die, if you have money and die, is 7% interest, like, what, annually? Or what? Bitcoin white. What is that, dude? Facepalm. Mail. What does that even mean? So anyway, dude, yeah, this is Nia. This is one of them. One of the Kangs. One of the Kang setups in the stock market we scanned and found, right? Beautiful, dude. Man, I'm just trying to make it 13 more minutes or so till the daily close, and then I can get out of here and get ready for the stream tonight, pregame tonight for patrons. Remember, if you want to be on stream and hang out and talk, get in the Discord, give your patron. Holy crap, dude, two more likes until Elon. Yeah. We're gonna do it, man. Once we do it, I'm playing it, man. NBC shares of Microsoft rose more than 2% Thursday to an all-time high after the company announced late Wednesday that it was boosting its dividend by 11%. Oh, little Conus, man. No one cares.
Is that a joint?
There it is. So weird, dude. Little fanboy. No one cares. Thanks, El Daniel. What's up, Orange Juice Man? At home Kangs. I've never played Omaha. I don't know. Never just really got into it. I was all about the No Limit Texas Hold'em. Just like Rounders, man, right? Was a big influence, of course, right? Got me into it a lot more. Okay. Tesla up $3 today. It's dude, bull flag maybe? On Tesla, right in that chop zone, the crazy resistance support area, consolidating after a bullish impulse, could rally. You break this, man. Talking about Gatfill, 263. I mean, the open's like, 259, but hey, man, it's possible. Breaking this, you could get much higher prices. Remember, the only reason this stopped was because earnings. You gapped down pretty violently, but create a two downslope and converging trend lines. You broke. You rallied. All Elon. Brad says he can't imagine someone having a better Discord if they have to go to other people's community to try and poach people, or at least say his is better than mine, right? Like, if you have to say you're the king, you're not the king, okay? You aren't a king at all. All right, so probably that Discord's trash. It wasn't the first time that loser said it too. It's so weird. It's like, I don't even know who the heck that person is. Some random person in crypto. I don't care, dude. I don't think anyone here cares either. All right. That's right, Jonathan, dude. I don't know. Vet Moonboy hates Elon Musk a lot. I think we trigger him sometimes with the, is that a joint? What's up, Jill? Dash was nearly ready, I think. Pretty good, son. Thank you.
Oh, AT&T, baby. This is one of my babies, all right? Exceeded the 618, and it sold off. Nearing the next overhead resistance, just couldn't quite get there. Too overbought on the daily. Probably divergence on the 4-hour. Sold off, pivoting a little bit. See if we get some a new pattern develops or something. And maybe we could roll. And look at this, man. Let's see how the parabola tool could work here. Let's see. I don't know, man. I guess I can't get it to... All right, so once that breaks, man, right? Not gonna be that great. You got one and two, and you're still going straight up, man. So that's pretty wild. Move up, the leg ups there, pretty insane. Why is Bitcoin so flat? Dude, if you care about altcoins performance, you want it to be kind of flat, dude. Bitcoin going up and down a lot, being volatile, is what has prevented these altcoins from performing. The push at the end of the 4-hour candle. Yeah, strength at the end of a day is always good, man. All right, but AT&T, hype in the chat, beautiful asset that has broken out the Momo shift and has continued its rally, and it looks like almost in parabolic fashion. Wow. Okay. Let's go to the Tether chart. Why not? Tether daily triangle, man. It's beautiful. It's freaking beautiful. How? Look at this, man. This type of price action you're getting. This upsloping support that I haven't touched since it was given its second anchor point, July 28th. But how are you showing green? How are you bullishly engulfing right now? How is this even possible, dude? After all that happened last night, taking me from the bar to here to stream kind of drunk to all the way back to 10,250. It's wild, man. Crazy rejection. Gartley, baby. So what is it we got? 5 minutes. 5 minutes. So just hanging out with y'all until then, running out the clock. And I'll go get some dinner and some beers. And we'll be back tonight. Hopefully it'll be a good one, right? Maybe we'll get some Baldy price action. You never know in this crazy market. Dude, I don't even have 1,000 views on my Ethereum update. That's terrible, dude. Dead content creator, man. Bitcoin's making to move again? What's it doing? I don't see it at 10,250. It was up at over 10,300 earlier. Graham, you always get banned. You don't know why? I don't either, man. Graham Gap. It's not Graham Dougherty, is it? I don't know that. That's a big pronoun. Okay. Where am I? Sean Watson, dude. I'm out in, Oregon somewhere. Okay. Sean, man. Like, I miss you, dude. I know you've been busy, man, but are you working tonight? Give me some good food at Blue Plate on 3rd. I could go over some good food, man. Tupo has a beer in the fridge. Fantastic, man. I do, but I'm on low supply. Price is off on the Tether pair. It is by $30, right? Spot price on, or for cash, right? Big on the US dollar for real is 10,280. is 10,250. Okay, I get what you're saying. So it's up a little bit more. So if I was looking at another candle, it would be like nicer, probably. You watch that-ish. That is still a vague pronoun. Just don't know, man. I mean, it is. It is. This is just Tether, man. This is not exactly the same. They're going to be off. Remember, like, the U.S. dollar, the whole run-up had been above Tether. Tether's always been lagging behind. Jonathan Klein, welcome. Thanks for the sub, dude. Thought I was in Connecticut. Connect, iCut. Yeah, dude. You name it, I'm there probably, if it looks like this. It's beautiful, man. You hear the birds chirping, chat? Cut the music. It's time for your local on the eights. Fantastic. All right. Hopefully you're all enjoying this wonderful sights and sound of nature. All these trees are the way they are. I don't know, man. Thanks, Joe M. Appreciate it, man. When does it end? Look, this is a daily time scale, Sean. I mean, you look, the apex is here. You, at this point, it could happen anytime, dude. Any effing time. Thanks, Jill. Is that a grackle? It could be, man. You can tell it's a treat by the way it is. Fantastical, man. I know, it was probably the chillest look on the eights ever, yeah. Really. All right, there it is. Let it be decreed that a new day has begun. And Bitcoin has recovered, right? It recovered from that violent drop last night to being in the green.
I love this so much with the nature sounds, yes.
It's nature, you misspelled it, dude. Thank you, Kanatomo, for the 3, 2, 1. Bat connect in the jar. So, 10,287. If you want to, we can get off the daily, go to the 4 hour, and just go back to the standard chart, right? The cash, right? Or the US dollar for real, pure. So as you can see, Sean Watson, dude, look how close we are to the downsloping resistance. So close, man. After bouncing off, again, critical areas, play the song. This is not dead yet. This was a higher low than this low. Still not dead. Okay? Still not dead. You can make it look like this if you need to. Like, to really... Okay? There. Whatever, man. This idea does not become invalid until you fall actually below C. Then it's dead. Okay. But beautiful, man. We gots to break. And this might be an area where if it can't break, this is where it might end, where you reject one more time and you then get destroyed.
Volatility troll tipped $25. Are we in the forest? I'm hunting wabbits and gingers today slash tonight. Grab a six pack of snake handler on me, brother. See you tonight.
Dude, it sucks, man. I could go get a growler of it. but I can't chug that. Nope. That's like literally asking to die. But yeah, I'll actually go get a growler full. That's fair. I'll just get some water beers too in case the worst happens. I don't know. I might need to turn down my chug attempt thing on the wheel because it's just nuts, dude. We terraformed outer space with trays, birds, and squirrels. Yes, we did. See, it sucks because I can't make it. It has to be a space background. Otherwise, it's going to look really bad. Okay. Light for the background. I can just turn it off, right? And make it really themed. Like that. Then it's like, whatever. My face looks fatter. Oh, I've been working out. So my muscles are bigger too. But thanks for the judge. Thanks for judging my face, hamster love. Too bad I can't judge yours. I'm sure I could figure out some flaws of you. But you don't stream. Oh, it's the same scrub who was talking about that other scrub's Discord. Gotcha. It's like, hey, dude, he's got, like, look at his low IQ. He spams comments. You're giving yourself away with your next account, dude. It's like, look what he's doing with his eye. I'm living my best life, man. This is what I do. I'm doing it for a living, dude. Professional live streamer. We got creeks in the back. We got leaves falling. We're changing the game. We're changing revolution into live stream game, dudes. And then he's over there calling my face fat. And it's like, who's really winning, dude? I'm destroying you, dude. Rent free in your mind. It's too easy, dude. Oh, I know I look good. Certainly, right? People just mad, bro. Celebration time, you'll go deep. Like Shiba Kings, y'all better get your alcohol or your water or your other thing, dude. Wayne Batson, what? Gross. Probably not expecting to share the heavy stuff. Just grab water beer. Yeah, dude, for sure. That's cool, though. Good idea. I know exactly where to get it. I might call them first to make sure they have it. Going there to get a growler fill and it's not stinking there, it's like the worst feeling ever. Okay. Goo call, Brad. What? Do I believe in aliens? I believe that the universe is so large that it would be almost insane to not believe there are other life forms out there like us. And it could be, we don't know where they are and their evolution, right? They could be just microorganisms. Or they could actually be really, really advanced life forms. But I think it's just like the numbers game, man. It's wild to think that there's not. It's just kind of, I think, almost narcissistic to think that we're that special, right? We're here. We're conscious. Why can't there be consciousness somewhere else, right? And you just said, you know, aliens, which means something that's not created here. Ancient aliens, man. No, I don't know about that, dude. I mean, you asked me a simple question, not what do you think of ancient aliens, all right? We are the aliens, T-Bone, maybe. Hi, my fellows. Thank you, dude. From 6-9, June 9th. From June 9th. A low to high. I thought it was deeper. I thought it was like a 75% retrace. Low to high. Yeah, it was like a 75% retrace. We're talking about 61.8% retrace. This is the 618, 9916. But you went lower than that. You retraced to deep levels. Value areas, could be argued, down there. It could be very rare, but again, man, it's not even, no one's asking, hey, do you think there are aliens out there that are more advanced than us? I don't know. Probably. Just the fact that we're here right now and I'm like live streaming,
leads you to believe maybe, you know, probably. Well, then you start talking about string theory, where there are multiverses. There's not just one universe. Then you think about the exponential increase in chance that there's, you know, alien life in another universe or multiverse. SD Magic, do you have links? If you have a link, I can put it up on stream right now. We can look at the aliens, the UFOs the Navy keeps spotting. Why would they tell us about it, dude? Alien harmonic pattern? Yeah, this was the alien. The cat, the bearish cat. So nearly 10,300 again. The new day hasn't brought in any kind of volatility, movement, price action, really. I mean, it's up nearly $18, so that's like literally whatever. Could literally lose that in a second. So I think just the thing to keep your eye on is the downside resistance. We're very close. Have your alerts set up at this point. The question is, will we hit it and fail, or will we break it and back test it and run, or will we just blast off, right? Those are pretty much the only scenarios. What is that, Jacob G? I don't know. That's weird. Well, maybe we just don't know exactly as we know it. But you know how much we don't know, dude? Tons of it. Everything's sleepy cat, dude. Yeah, for sure. So we just cracked 10.3 for a second. And, yeah. Very good. So, like, you know, minor overhead resistance around 10,430. Right here. I mean, yeah, you see it, right? A lot of it. Or a decent amount anyway. It's just, it's like a pivot point. 10.5 to 10.5. That's like that next area. Where's my downside resistance at? What do you mean? Right here. You not see it? I'm literally identifying it with my cursor. So it never settles. Thanks for the pumpkin, the coffee, the eight ball, the tree, the rainbow, and the handshake, dude. Fist bump. Bitcoin is the alien. That's an interesting way to look at it, I guess. I've never heard anyone call Bitcoin literally an alien before. Maybe. Probably not, though. It's an invention by men. Look around. Thanks for the 463 likes. When's the last time? I'm going to look this up. The last time I had 463 likes on a stream, man. It's been a minute, maybe. Okay. All right. I had 507 likes. Episode 679. And we're on 683 right now. So it wasn't that long ago, actually. We had more. Yeah. So I thought it was going to be crazier. I bet. I gamble only on college football. Joe M. All right. That's like the only thing I bet on. I mean, trading is also a form of gambling. You have to look at it like that. Like, thanks for the follow on Twitter, man. Mr. Mobile Gaming, you're speaking for me, dude. You have almost as many likes as viewers. Yeah, well, it's good. I mean, it shows
the community, right? The community comes and goes, right? They got things to do. They come in, watch, get analysis, and they do something else. And it's like they're just here. They're showing support. That's what that means, dude. So, I don't know, man. I guess I can just leave y'all at that. I've been live now over two. I mean, 2 hours, 11 minutes. So, over time. But, yeah, I can just come back later. And that's it. 11 Eastern tonight. Party stream. Drinking stream. Having fun stream. All right. I'm going to talk about everything under the sun. Okay. So, thank y'all so freaking much for the likes, love, support, the contributions, everything, man, woman, and child, all y'all. Yeah, so I will be back. So until next time, respect the T.A. Fibonacci from your low point to high point, but as you can see, it's a critical area.
Time scales.